Hi, I'm Paul. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. Today, we will look at the basic building blocks of economics, which are divided into 10 principles. In this video, we'll cover principles 5, 6, and 7. Now, if we didn't engage in trade, then we'd have to do everything ourselves. Everything from growing our own vegetables, cutting our own hair, and building our own houses, which isn't the most efficient way to go about things. However, with trade, we can introduce specialization and trading to meet most of our mutual needs. What's true on the individual level is also true on the country level. Countries can benefit from trade and specialization. Trade allows some countries to specialize in the products or services that they excel at, and goods that can be produced at a cheaper cost in the home country should be sold abroad, while those that can be produced at a cheaper cost elsewhere can be imported. This allows consumers to enjoy a greater variety of goods and services. Organizing an economy means determining what kinds of goods and services gets to produce, who gets to produce them, what kind of quantity, but also who gets to consume them at the end. In a market economy, economic activity is based on the decentralized decisions of millions or even billions of individuals, and they interact and compete in a marketplace for goods and services. There is no central force that determines who gets to buy and who gets to make each one good or services. Contrast that to a centrally planned economy, where a central planner, usually the government, determines who are the buyers in the economy and who are the sellers in the economy, and how much output when goods and services gets to be produced. The market economy works without a central planner due to the nature of prices. Since prices in the markets can adjust freely, it really has information value, where prices represent value to the buyer and also reflects costs to the seller. Principle 7 sounds contradictory to Principle 6 on the surface, since in Principle 6 we said that free market economies operate well independently, but Principle 7 suggests that we might need the role of government in order for markets to be run efficiently. So let's dive deep into what the role of government is. The role of government in a free market economy is really twofold. One, it's to maintain property rights, and two, it's to prevent market failure. Now, economic actors are not incentivized to work and produce if there is a very high risk of their property being stolen. Thus, it's the role of the government in order to protect property, and the government ensures that there are proper rules, regulations, and institutions where property rights are enforced. There are two types of market failure that the government tries to prevent: externalities and excessive market power. Externalities is also known as the bystander effect, where a third party's well-being is being affected by a transaction that happens between two economic actors. Imagine a firm located next to a river. The firm dumps toxins from production into the river. This pollutes the river and affects the well-being of everyone that lives near the river. This is an example of an externality problem where a third party is impacted without being the consumer nor producer of the product. Excessive market power is a problem that occurs when a single buyer or single seller exerts an enormous amount of influence on the price or quantity of a goods and services sold in a particular industry. This happens commonly in monopoly industries. Some of the ways that the government tries to prevent the problems faced by externalities or excessive market power is by changing taxation policies, introducing quotas, or introducing more regulation to a particular industry. If you want to explore these topics more in depth, please visit Chegg, where you can see additional topic videos, view example problems, or speak to one of our Chegg subject matter experts. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you at Chegg.